My name is Rhys Dawkins, and I am the most intelligent professional wrestler on this side of the globe. And this is the Scottish Wrestling Network.
Welcome to the latest edition of the SWN Podcast. I'm your host, as always, Billy. And it took me a while, but I was able to track down my next guest. As you can see, if you're watching the video version of the podcast, I have found, just fresh off his recent victory at FPWA versus New Wave Wrestling Academy, it's the hardest man in Fife. It's Tommy Kartel. Welcome to the show.
Reigning, defending, undisputed hardest man in Fife, Billy Strachan. Thank you very much for the introduction.
That's fine. I might just clip that and just say the hardest man in Fife, Billy Strachan, and just maybe just keep that for myself. But thank you for joining me. I'm very, very excited to have you on the show because I've been seeing your exploits on social media when it comes to what you've been doing and seeing your journey of being the hardest man of Fife. And I thought, I've got to get this guy on. I've got to at least have a chat, find out more about this elusive man, this hardest wrestler in Fife. So if you indulge me, I've got some questions. We've got some stuff through Instagram, through Twitter as well, which we'll go through. I know that you like to keep yourself to yourself, but hopefully we can...
If it's one thing people will say about Tommy Kartel, he's very reserved, he's very humble. Billy, you know, when you reached out to me, I was a little bit hesitant about coming on, you know. I'm quite shy, as you say, quite reserved. I don't like to talk. I like to let my actions do the talking for me, Billy. I'm not the kind of guy who gets on social media, posts a video and, you know, goes off on one. That's not Tommy Kartel at all. I think my coach Andy Roberts has been on recently, and I think he had some very nice things to say about me as well.
He did.
I realise, you know, I've seen your past guests last couple of episodes. You've had some big hitters, and you've had the big demos, you've had the Grados, Andy Roberts, he's been around for a wee while. It's only natural that Tommy Kartel should be on that echelon of Scottish talent.
Absolutely. I mean, season 5 has been incredible with the likes of, like you say, Grado, and I've had Mike Mondo on as well, and Andy Roberts. So
he's a spirited guy, isn't he?
He's a little bit, but we were able to come to understanding for the time that we spoke. So it was fine. Before and after, I was told straight out, I've got to make sure this is the best episode I ever put out. So he's really set the bar for me at this point, where I'm going to have to make every episode the best of the best, because Andy Roberts has been on and he's told me so. So we've got to make that right. So of course, hardest man in Fife, you've been a fighter. What I've learned so far is you've fought for everything that you've got, for everything you've earned. But when it comes to fighting, how did you make the leap then to go, right, you know what? I like this pro wrestling stuff. Let's give this a bash.
Excellent question, Billy. Excellent question. You're right. The hardest man in Fife could go into any discipline he wanted. Boxing, you know, I've seen if KSI can do it, Tommy Kartel can do it. MMA, acting, dodgeball. Yeah, I could do it all. Why pro wrestling? Pro wrestling is the toughest, most demanding sport there is. There's no weight classes in pro wrestling, Billy. Tommy Kartel is about a lean, mean 100 kilograms. He can get in there with a boy 200 kilograms. He can get in there with a boy 50 kilograms as well. Easy paycheck. There's the potential in Scotland, Billy. As you know yourself, there's, 20, 25 odd promotions in Scotland.
Yeah.
There's the potential that you could be doing this every weekend. Tommy Kartel went to the cage, went to do a wee bit of the MMA. Maybe Tommy Kartel's only fighting once every 8 months. So enough of the hardest man in Fife. I've said this before, Billy. I want not just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I want all the hard men coming right at me, Billy. Mm-hmm. And I can get that through wrestling.
Right, so it's just a case of getting paid to batter folk once a week or anytime you want.
Billy. Yeah. Pro wrestling's always appealed to me, you know. You've seen the WrestleManias, the Survivor Series, the SummerSlams, the Royal Rumbles, the fireworks, the entrance, the girls, the money. Yeah, I've always envisioned myself as a bit of a modern-day Ric Flair. I think we have a lot in common. Share a very, very similar in-ring style, don't we?
From what I've seen, absolutely. Is there a case of where you see these kind of hybrid talents in WWE? For example, Matt Riddle, Brock Lesnar, even guys like Logan Paul as well, who's kind of who's transitioned himself from being a YouTuber to doing boxing, YouTube boxing, and then into the ring, in the ring. So when you see guys like this, is this just, it's just like, well, Tom Kartel can do that. If these guys can make the leap, there's no stopping myself.
Tommy Kartel is in pro wrestling right now. Perhaps Tommy Kartel's in one pro wrestling when he's 40, 50 years old. Billy, you'll know yourself, you're a man who keeps stats on Scottish wrestling. You know Tommy Kartel has a 100% record in Scottish wrestling. That's a streak that can't go on forever, Billy. That's going to become a thing where I've beaten every single person in Scotland. Where am I going from there? Maybe I need to move into a different discipline. Maybe Tommy Kartel needs to go into the music industry, into acting, on the stage. I've seen what guys like Grado have done, you know? So had a good run. Tommy Kartel, like a piece of that pie as well.
Well, you're speaking of moving into the music industry. That actually leads me into your first match. Well, the first match I have recorded, anyway, in my stat sheet here, was, of course, at Discovery Wrestling. And this all brought about during the bitter feud. At the time, it was Andy Wilde and Joe Hendry, of course, who's now Andy Roberts. And it came to head with you guys, Team FPWA, taking on Team Joe Hendry in Discovery. So this is, as I said, noted as your debut match. You're representing your school, FPWA. And you're going in to fight Joe Hendry's students, who, of course, who's again, another hybrid athlete. Of course, coming into your first match then, you've fought, you've battered people, but this time it's a bit more, maybe a bit more disciplined. You had to kind of do a little bit of showboating, a little bit of entertainment to go with it. Was there any trepidation going into that first match?
Naturally, I felt it was a little bit of a handicap match as well, because I had that idiot Frank Gallo on my team. Have you ever seen Frank Gallo?
He's a bit of a wild man from what I've seen.
Bit of a wild man, yeah. So Frank Gallo, in that very match, Billy, if you've seen the footage, headbutts himself on that rope so many times that he cuts himself. How am I supposed to team with that? Despite that, helped pick up the win. And it would have been obvious for Andy Roberts when that challenge is laid out. Who's he going to get? Who represents the best chance of bringing victory home to FPWA? Okay, he's put Frank Gallo in there. I'm not sure why he's done that. But myself and Beth Shorty at the time, we brought it home for FPW. And I've got a lot of time for Joe Hendry. That's one of the most talented guys there is. You know, Ashley Vega was on the team that day. Ryan Richards, who I've obviously had my issues with. But we got in there, we got the job done. And that was the start of Tommy Kartel's streak in Scottish wrestling.
Of course, Ryan Richards being a bit of a thorn in your side, I was noticing there was some shenanigans in a match with yourself at Discovery as well. So, but what was it like? Of course, Discovery being one of the biggest companies in Scotland, certainly probably up there in Europe as well. So, FPWA at the time didn't have a promotion, so to speak. They had a training facility which you were able to learn a little bit more about the intricate side of pro wrestling. Mm-hmm. But no, making a debut, one of the biggest promotions, like you said, there was a little bit of trepidation, but was it just like, of course I'm making a debut for one of the biggest companies in Europe right now. Was there any doubt in your mind that Discovery was the place to begin your journey?
No doubt in my mind, Billy. When opportunity knocks, you've got to take it. Now, it's well documented that I'd already conquered Fife by that point. So it was only natural I'd jump across the Forth Bridge and have a crack at Edinburgh as well. Discovery Wrestling, you say it's a great promotion, great fans. One of the few sets of fans that actually respect Tommy Kartel and show him the love and appreciation he deserves. I like Discovery Wrestling. I like their fans. Smart people.
So we'll speak about it then, maybe a bunch of fans that don't like Tommy Kartel as much, perhaps. Well, is the Fife fans, Fife Pro Wrestling Asylum, whether it's jealousy, I don't know. That's for them to decide and for you to shoulder, I suppose. Got December 2021, so this is the month after Discovery. You've made your official FPWA. I think it was actually a showcase show that we somehow were able to nab the results for, but it was Frank Gallo that you ended up in the ring with. So,
like I say, Billy, you know, I've had to carry that man to a victory at Discovery Wrestle in the previous month. I really just had to let my frustrations out on him. He's a big ginger jabroni, if you want my opinion on Frank Gallo. You know, I'm not sure if you've seen what he did in the most recent FPWA show, Billy.
I saw his refereeing skills. I saw a little clip about that.
But that is not a man who is a licensed and accredited referee. And you've got Frank Gallo, who can't, he just can't hack anyone else having the spotlight. There he is, opening match, main event, all over the place. Everybody loves Frank Gallo.
Didn't he also... He's also popped up in places like Iron Girders and community pro wrestling as well. So yeah, is he just the guy that's we were talking about Ryan Richards being a thorn in your side? Is Frank Gallo just the opposite of everything that Tommy Kartel represents?
I would think so. Tommy Kartel, you know, he's a good looking young tanned guy. Frank Gallo, paler than a sheet, isn't he? Great competitor, great athlete, Frank Gallo. Absolutely crazy, out of his mind. And you're going to get that. You're going to get... It takes a crazy individual to want to get one-on-one with Tommy Kartel. Mm-hmm. Frank Gallo found out last year that crazy for trying.
We'll talk about the of course, you'd be the hardest man of Fife, but one match I really want to get in about is probably one of your first five matches, maybe, was against one of the hardest wrestlers in the world. Not just in Fife. Up there, at the very least, if you could say so yourself, was your match against BT Gunn. So, of course, at this point, you hadn't won the accolade of being the hardest man of Fife, even though you said yourself you're already the hardest man of Fife. But you're coming up against the oddity BT Gunn, who's got the hardest chops, who's one of the most toughest individuals to ever step foot in wrestling. Before we talk about the Fatal Fife Way and all that, what was it like in the ring with BT Gunn?
Well, you know, as I said in a video that went viral, that did over 20,000 hits on Instagram, that BT Gunn match was a bit of a coming out moment for Tommy Kartel. That was the match where Tommy Kartel realised that he was the hardest man of Fife. Because if you can beat BT Gunn, that's a man who's been around, 15, 20 years, right? That's a man who's headlined shows at the Hydro on two belts in one night. That's a man who's beaten every top guy that's come through Scotland. That's a man who's stunned the death matches. He's you know, rolled around in the thumbtacks, the barbed wire. That's a tough guy, like you say. And if you can beat him, you must be pretty hard yourself. That was really, after that match, you know, the moment I realised, I'm a pretty hard guy myself, Billy. And I should be letting people know about this more.
That was it. When as soon as I saw that result, I saw the things coming out of it against social media, because that's where some of my little hub here up in Elgin. So I get a lot of my information through the interweb. I was just seeing a lot of comments say, this Tommy Kartel's the guy you need to keep an eye on. He just beat BT Gunn after winning a battle royal to start off the show as well. So it's not even like you're coming in 100%.
And perhaps, you know, going into that match, maybe Tommy Kartel's not heavily fancied. Maybe William Hill don't have Tommy Kartel at evens to beat BT Gunn. But I did it. It's there. You've got footage. You've got the match results, Billy.
Exactly. And I trust my source when it comes to the results as well. So we're not going to go into every single match that you've had, because that would just be a hide is nothing, because it'll just be Tommy Kartel wins. And then next one, Tommy Kartel wins. Because as you say, you've been unpinned, unsubmitted in your career so far. And it's coming up to a year and a half that you've been a licensed professional wrestler, not just the hardest man in Fife in general. But we will talk about the Fatal Five Way. So this is a concept created by Fife Pro Wrestling Asylum, a very interesting concept, because it could be won at any time, from what I understand. So it doesn't matter if you're the fourth man in, it could be all over by the time you get there. When you were presented with the
one concept. So the concept, the Fatal Fife Way to determine who's the hardest person in Fife. Okay. Two competitors start. They wrestle for 2 minutes. And after every minute on the timer, enters another competitor. So it becomes, from a singles match, you've got a three-way dance. You know, you've got two other people coming right at you. It becomes a fatal four-way. And then fifth person can come out. Yes, like you say, Billy, that match can end at any time. You know, if I'm starting the ring like I usually do, because I'm the hardest man in Fife, I want to be out there for the whole time. I want every single person to face me one-on-one. You know, I could finish a match 30 seconds in, a minute. It's not happened yet, Billy.
It's not impossible.
No, it's not impossible.
Going through the...
Pinfall, so,
go through the guys that you
actually...
Sorry, I interrupted you there. You're still going through the concept. I'll let you finish.
No disqualifications, no countouts. The hardest match in Scottish pro wrestling today.
So going through the guys that you're in the ring with, and it's a pretty stacked lineup of experience and also styles. Because we've got Johnny Lyons, of course. We love Johnny Lyons. I've had the pleasure of speaking to Johnny Lyons, and
you love Johnny Lyons.
The SWN Royal Wee, we'll say that Johnny Lyons. He is interesting. I think you possibly might put him in the same category as Frank Gallo. Is a bit out there when it comes to being Johnny Lyons. Of course, Craig Berry, of course, the big lad. One of the big lads, Judas Gray, who has sent in a question that we'll possibly get to, and someone who, again, you seem to be like a rose. You have a lot of thorns on your side. You've got Talon Jr. as well. So,
Talon Jr. is always politicking his way into the fatal five-way or into some other kind of big match. That there's a man who's a silver-tongued devil, a snake oil merchant. Talon Jr., you've got to watch out for him. Snake in the grass.
So with that, so that's loads of styles. Let's say you've got your veteran of Johnny Lyons, you've got your big powerhouse of Craig Berry, you've got your high-flying Talon Jr., whatever Judas Gray wants to present himself for that particular day, because he seems to have a little bit of everything coming from a Joe Henry school to kind of give you quite a few tools in your arsenal. Of course, you had no doubts. You're the hardest man in Fife, so there's no doubts you were going to win, but was there any moments where you thought this match might be getting away from you?
You never know, man. There's nothing to stop Johnny Lyons pinning Craig Berry. There's nothing to stop Talon Jr. pinning Judas Gray. Hey, if Talon Jr. wants to pin Judas Gray, there's nothing Tommy Kartel can do about that. But it's about strategy as well. I'll tell you how I won that match, Billy. Right? I saw them all one by one. Here comes Johnny Lyons flying over the top rope. Here comes Talon Jr. with this ridiculous backflip. Nearly took out half the crowd. A health and safety hazard. Now, see, Judas Gray just can't help himself, can he? There he is. G-ing up the crowd. Judas Gray's got to get his dive in as well. He hits that rope. Bang! I pop him up. I pin him. 1, 2, 3. Didn't they see that coming? And that's what it's about. It's not just about being the hardest, Billy. It's about being the most strategic as well and picking your moments.
So you also say you're not only the hardest man in Fife, but possibly the smartest man in Fife as well.
Right. You said it, Billy. You said it.
Of course. We do have a question from Judas Gray. One I'm fairly sure you're not going to answer, but we'll get to it. The first one is, though, thoughts on the Talon family. So you've already mentioned snake in the grass, silver tongue. I've seen footage of this Talon senior fella as well. What are your thoughts on the Talon family?
Yeah, I've never had... displeasure of meeting Talon Sr. myself. I've heard the stories. Talon Jr., however, on the other hand, you know, I've called Talon Jr. a snake in the grass. This one is much worse. You know, he's small in stature, but that ego on that child, massive. And I had to put him in his place. Well, you remember when Talon Jr. was entering the Fatal Five-Way, he entered that by sneaking up behind me in a car park. Who does that? Who starts? Who instigates in a car park? There I was, explaining politely to Talon Jr. that this is the hardest man in Fife space, and he isn't the hardest man in Fife. And there is Talon Jr. creeping up behind me with his cameraman. I didn't realise there was a camera on me, Billy. Making himself look all big and tough, heading into the Fatal Five-Way. Well, he's 0-2, isn't he?
He is. Is there something against, I don't know if you've got something against trusting someone that has a mask, whether they won't show their face. Is there anything in that at all that psychologically, be like, why would you trust anyone that's not showing their face?
You know what they say, Billy, yeah. There's nothing to be gained from fighting an ugly person. They've got nothing to lose. There's a reason they're hiding behind masks. Seen Talon Jr.'s eyes. Got one red eye, one black. Imagine what the rest of his face looks like.
That is a t-shirt waiting to happen. Nothing to gain from fighting ugly people. That's in there. That's making a note of that to go with my t-shirt collection. Obviously all royalties to yourself. Judas Gray did also ask DMG. I don't know if you're aware of DMG. I'm sure he's explained it to you.
Judas Gray's he's a weird chap. All the talent in the world, perceptively strong, but just a really weird young man, isn't he? DMG. Do you want to explain that to me, Billy?
Not really, no.
That's that question.
I've had to explain it like to the last five guests.
Was 15 seconds.
I've had to explain it to the last five guests, and I'm really sad now that I seem to be his errand boy for his little club. So no, I will not explain it. He can do it himself.
You've got to give him a question, Bargo.
I think so. I think possibly. If he keeps asking it, though, I'm going to get back on just to get clear the air. He still said more. So yeah, we'll two more. Who's your favourite import that occasionally trains with you? So sure that your heart's mad at Fife. You've got to train with people. You've got to get their weaknesses in the brain. Any favourites that you have with you?
Any favourite training partners?
Yeah.
There's a turnbuckle I like to beat up.
Ah, the old George Animal Steel.
Nah, no particular. Animal Steel. Big tasty snack. favourite training partners are. They're all just bodies to me, Billy. All just bodies.
That's fair. And is Fife
I'm assuming Judas Gray was hoping I would see himself.
Of course, yeah. I mean, he's got to get
in the inbox to try and put himself over when it's my time. When it's Judas Gray's podcast, he can talk about himself then.
And you can check the archives and you can find it yourself. We've got and the final one is Fife as bad as they say?
Depends, Bill. Have you ever been to Fife?
I have not had the pleasure to be to enter the beautiful kingdom of Fife, even though I've heard it is a beautiful kingdom.
It is a beautiful kingdom. Really safe place as well, because as the hardest man in Fife, I preside over these lands. And I make sure it's safe for podcast hosts. I make sure it's safe for the general public at large. There's no trouble here. There's no trouble in Fife. And when there is, we have a Fife way.
That's good to hear, good to know, because there's some places I can't really go now for fear of promoters wanting to not get into my DMs, but get into some sort of rammy. And I'm nae that kind of guy. That's nae my life. I'm just a media person. I was going to call myself personality.
You're the man who gives people a platform to come on and speak about their pro wrestling. You know, people should appreciate it for that.
Exactly. Exactly.
You can clip that and you can quote that, Billy. The hardest man in Fife.
That's possibly the nicest thing you've ever said to someone that's not just on your way. We've got Radlad, Gaz Williams. We'll finish through the Twitter questions and then we can get back onto Tommy Cartel's journey. He's just asked why you're so tall. So do you do anything in particular to make yourself taller?
Weighted calf raises.
There we go. I wasn't expecting it. That wasn't the answer I expected, but I didn't know what to expect. So I'll bear that in mind for myself as well, because I'm a pudgy 5'10", so I could possibly get that to 6 if I really tried. And lastly, we have
5'10" average. Really.
I know, but I don't want to be average. I want to be above average. That's the Mike Sanders way. I've aged myself.
I want to be a genetic freak, a genetic jackhammer.
Well, that's what my wife tells me. Right, so we've got the last question we have on Twitter. I'm seeing my connection's unstable, so I don't know if I may need to repeat it. We've got Ashley Vega, which actually leads us nicely back onto your journey. Just asking, are you excited to see her on Thursday? So, of course, you're in the Fife way with Ashley Vega, which you won. But what are your thoughts on Ashley?
I'm assuming this is an archived question and she meant this Thursday past.
She did. Unless you got so me with her.
No, so I tried to extend an olive branch to Ashley during that match. No, she got up on the apron. She was giving me a wee bit of a dance. I thought, you know, we're in the middle of a nightclub. There's a disco ball up there. I thought I'd give a wee bit of a dance back as well. I approaches her, as you do in a nightclub. She pulls the rope down on me. Out the ring I go. Ah, I've not got any time for Ashley Vega after that.
That's the trust gone. You're the one chance with Tommy Cartel.
You look like an idiot in front of my people. In front of the people of Fife.
So speaking of that match, of course, you retained your Fatal Fife-Way kind of crown, so to speak. Where was it? It was through a gauntlet initially. That was November 2022. Well, it was just an open challenge. But I'm assuming if someone was had the stones to beat you, they would have been able to claim themselves the hardest man in Fife. Interestingly enough, though, your last opponent in that, according to my notes here, was Hunter Sampson, which the name will probably pop up a little bit later on. But defending it in a gauntlet, how do you find that in comparison to defending your honour of the hardest man in Fife in the Fife way?
Tommy Kartel was looking to give something back to the people of Fife with that hard man invitational, that gauntlet. I was trying to really put a spotlight on, you know, the young lads who thought they were hard, who fancied having a go. But also to keep the people in leaving in line, to let them know that if you jump across that barrier and you have a go at the hardest man of Fife, this is what's going to happen. I beat one, two, three people back to back. And I'll do it again. But my biggest issue with these shows at Truth Nightclub, Billy, are the amount of dads in attendance. And I know what they're all thinking. I know they're sitting there because they've taken me, Johnny and Jenny to the wrestling. And they're thinking, do you know what? I could have a go at him. And as I grabbed the microphone on the last show at the Truth, I said, you know what? You might be a tough guy in your home. You might be a tough guy in your plumbing business. You may be a tough guy in the British Legion. You're not a tough guy in this ring. And on that night, I proved that I had three people who thought they were tough guys, who thought they were hard men. I took them all out, Billy.
And then it led us on to the month after, where you actually were in another Fife way. Of course, and I was checking the names in this. The names are incredible, even though you had to face Hal Jr. again in it. But Leighton Buzzard, of course, current ISW World Heavyweight Champion, Moxie Malone, the current Iron Girders, King of the Fling, and you've got LJ Cleary, world traveled, of course, from Ireland. So this is a very, almost international contest for the Fife Way. And of course, you have opened up to the world now. But that's a heavy, heavy set of opponents you've got there. Leighton Buzzard, like I said, and Tal Jr., wherever he's from. But Leighton Buzzard, Moxie Malone, LJ Cleary, and Talon. So that's it's just bodies.
The thing is, like you say, Billy, you've got a very impressive lineup there. Where as much as you like to rag on Talon Jr., that's a very talented individual, you know. Moxie Malone, a champion in Glasgow. Leighton Buzzard, ICW world champion, wrestling all over Europe, wrestles in America, Canada. LJ Cleary, the same, he's wrestled everywhere. You want to talk about trepidation? You know, that match maybe put the willies into Tommy Kartel a little bit. He's thinking, do you know what, these are some pretty experienced guys. How am I going to overcome the odds and come out hardest man in Fife again? But it's all just about seizing your opportunity. There, I saw Moxie Malone with that pin. One, two, three, pick her up, throw her out, get the pin myself, get the win. Hey, Billy, it was a hard contest, and maybe I survived by just a fraction, but it's not about, you know, how much the ball goes over the line by. It's just about getting that VAR check and making sure it did. And Tommy Kartel ended another year undefeated in Scotland.
When it comes to like an opponent like LJ Cleary or Leighton Buzzard, of course, Andy Roberts would have no doubt, well, definitely had a good feud with Leighton Buzzard, especially. But is he a guy that you would possibly try and pick the brain of to get inside the minds of these opponents? Is there anyone that you do find that you're the hardest man of Fife, but you must have a sounding board somewhere that you could possibly pick some information from?
I'll tell you the advantage that I have over LG Cleary and Leighton Buzzard that they don't have over me. I can go on YouTube and go on Fight TV, and I can type in Leighton Buzzard, LG Cleary. I can see them wrestle each other. I can sit and study that and see, you know, what they do. What are their strengths? What are their weak points? There's not much footage of Tommy Kartel out there. Most of my fights have happened in bars. And there's a reason you can't post that footage on YouTube. It's violent. It's aggressive. You know, they're coming into the Lion's Den and they're not prepared. That's the advantage I have of these guys. These guys, incredibly talented guys. Wealth of experience. I'm a bit of an unknown factor to them. The only thing I'm really concerned about is the fate of Fife when becoming the hardest men on Fife. You've got these guys flying all over Europe, America, Canada, winning championships. How much thought have they given Tommy Kartel?
That's a very well-articulated point as well. Is that something that you, as we mentioned right at the start, of course, you are reserved. You like to make your actions do the talking more. But are you conscious about not having a lot of your match footage online to try and keep yourself as the unknown factor?
Probably so, didn't it, Billy? You know, Tommy Kartel's a very impressive performer. If more people were seeing Tommy Kartel online, it would surely result in Tommy Kartel getting the phone up, getting the DMs that you DM'd me yourself, and offering me a chance to come and fight their hard men in different locations, not just around Scotland, but further afield. Then again, as we've already talked about, gives opponents an opportunity to get to know me a little bit better, to get to know my weaknesses, my strengths. It's a balancing act, isn't it, Billy? You want people to know who you are, and believe me, everybody in Fife does, but Tommy Kartel's looking about expanding his conglomerate, coming outside of Fife. That's my goal for the rest of the year.
So there was a little bit of interference there. From what I'm gathering, though, is you've conquered Fife, and you're wanting to start expanding your Kartel, I suppose, into other kingdoms, other counties, and showing who's the hardest in Scotland.
I think it's going to be a pretty exciting announcement on those fronts soon, Billy. You just keep your eyes on my Instagram page, and you'll see what Tommy Kartel's got in his sights for next month.
I will certainly do that. Speaking of Instagram, we've got again a bunch of questions through Instagram, so we'll try and go through those, and hopefully there isn't anything that'll set you off. So I've got because I know that I'm on Zoom, we're far away from each other. Generally, nothing should happen to me, but if I do get a question possibly into your ire, then I've got to wait maybe 3 hours, and I might end up finding out why you're the hardest man in Fife. So we've got Logan Smith here. He's answered a couple. He's asked a couple of questions. He just asked, "What's the best part of training at FPWA?" So is there anything that possibly that you've learned to control possibly as the hardest man in Fife?
Tell you something, Billy. You don't do a lot of rope running when you're in a bar fight. You don't do a lot of rolling around. The FPWA is a great facility. And I'm Fife's hardest man. It makes the most sense that I would train in Fife as well. Pass all my knowledge to the next generation. You know, Andy Roberts, man, he's a hard training guy himself. He puts me through my paces. I'm there twice a week, every week. Why would I go anywhere else?
Absolutely. Of course, you did show that you like to pass on your wisdom, of course, when you were speaking to Zach Swift in the run-up to the most recent Truth Show for SWA.
Here's my issue, Billy. Now, I've got a lot of experience, a lot of wisdom to pass on to the younger guys like Zach Swift. And all I was trying to recommend was that, you know what, I felt he was ego-lifting. I felt those dumbbells were a wee bit too heavy for him. I was thinking about his poor rotator cuffs. I saw a nice set of 6 kilogram pink dumbbells in the corner, and I thought they'd be better suited for Zach Swift. And what do I get? You help a man out in the gym, you give him a little bit of free advice, and he cuts a promo on you. He gets in your face and challenges you to a 5-way match. Last time I help anybody at the gym, Billy.
It's a disrespect. I mean, I haven't set foot in the gym in a very long time, but from what I understand is there's time and place for these arguments. If you spot a brother, if you spot someone that needs a little bit of help, you give them a little bit of help.
That's all I was doing. Billy, nobody's ever had an issue with somebody coming across in a gym and giving them free advice. That's the nicest thing you could possibly do to a person. Zach Swift, you know, he's a great up-and-coming talent, and I was only thinking about his longevity, and this is what I get thrown right back in my face.
Disrespect. So we've got Logan Smith as well. We've pretty much answered this quite a few times now, but just as a overall, actually no, I'll get back to Logan's, because Zach Swift got a question in, which I think kind of fits in there.
Rookie's come crawling back.
So he has asked, why did he have to cheat to win the Fatal Fife Way again? Now, before we go any further, I have seen some footage of Hunter Thompson turning up, but as you've said, pinfall, submission, no disqualification. Continue.
Look. Let me get this straight. Hunter Sampson, my right-hand man, the second hardest man in Fife. A lab experiment, a genetic freak. And we've I took him out there for a field test. You know, I'm taking him under my wing, giving him the benefit of my wisdom. But also, Billy, there was 200 witnesses there that could attest to the fact that I grabbed that microphone before the start of the five-way, and I specifically told Hunter Sampson, I do not want you to interfere in my match. If I'm in a Boston Crab and Hunter Sampson interferes in my match, there's nothing I can do about it. Yes, I'll grasp the opportunity he's presented me. But I wasn't happy with him. Hey, I'm a technical wizard. I was going to counter that hold, and I was going to win that match just fine. Hunter Sampson, he's a wise man once said. He's got a long way to go.
So some words were exchanged, possibly after the match, backstage with Hunter. Just tell him to listen to the hardest man.
That's it. And that's how you go from the second hardest man to the 1.5 hardest man.
That's it. So possibly, I mean, I don't know what's coming up. I know that FPWA have got are visiting Wales as well for another show. So another bit of there. Yeah, they announced it at the show itself. So no, actually, no, didn't. The New Wave announced it. They've got FPWA. So I don't know if your expansion goes to Wales.
Did they announce that, Billy?
I have no matches announced, so I don't know. I just know the show's happening.
Very interesting, isn't it?
Yeah,
cool place for the hardest man in Fife to pop up, wouldn't it?
Exactly. That would be, that's Doctor Who country. That's anything can happen, I suppose, in Wales.
Yeah, some big bruising guys down in New Wave, aren't there?
But, I mean,
it's put all them there. I think Tommy. Yeah.
Is there anyone you have an eye on down there at New Wave? I mean, you saw a couple of the guys up here. So the Greedy Souls, you got to see as Nico Angelo. You got Wild Boar, of course. Was there anyone that was like, I would like, maybe get you in the Fatal Five Way so I can show you that I'm the hardest man in Fife?
It's a high pedigree over there. They do things a wee bit differently there in Wales. It's not always easy to be the hardest man in Wales, is it?
I know. I mean, who is the hardest man in Wales?
We'll find out eventually if Tommy Kartel goes down next month, which I'm not saying he is.
There we go. We'll keep that as a wee teaser. So we've got Robbie Balfour, Robert Balfour, of the PAR Oak Academy. Of course, someone who, of course, you guided to victory at one of the showcase shows, one of the first FPWA showcase shows. He's just asked, why are you such a chocolate?
Firstly, Bill, you really have done your research, haven't you? Secondly, I've no idea what Robbie, Robert, Woke, R, Chad, Balfour means by that. I'm assuming it's a compliment. I've no idea. I think I'll pass on that question, Billy.
Maybe she's called you sweet.
Stupid question.
We just called you a sweet.
Yeah, it looks sweet.
We've got Logan Smith will go, how does it feel to be the hardest man in Fife? You know, we've discussed it at length here, but I haven't asked you though, how does it feel to be the hardest man in Fife? So Logan's done it for me.
There's a lot of responsibility that comes with being the hardest man in Fife. As we've spoken about earlier, Billy, I keep this place safe for humble podcasters like yourself. There's also a big target on my back 24/7. That's why I've enlisted the services of Hunter Sampson. I need somebody watching my back. Because, you know, I'm always at the front, left, right, good night, wee Barry backhand. I've got eyes in the back of my head, Billy. When you're the top dog, everybody's gunning for you. So how does it feel? You know, I live life on the edge, Billy, but every day's a struggle. It's not just about getting to the top and being the hardest man in Fife, it's about staying there. These five ways, man, they ain't easy to win. I've done it 3 times in a row, Billy.
So it's staying humble, of course, as well, also helps with being the hardest man for Fife, I'm sure.
Of course, of course. So humble and hard.
Humble and hard, and again, our t-shirt. So the last question I've got through social media is one that I'm a little bit worried to ask you, I'll be perfectly honest with you, but it's from a guy called Washua_Jill. I don't know if that's a code name of any sort. I just put, this isn't a question, but you know the hardest man in Fife.
Is this Judas Gray's burner account?
But quite possibly.
It's not a question, it's a statement. You were supposed to submit questions. What did he call himself? Washing machine underscore something.
What, wash you at underscore Jill? I don't know if that's I don't know.
Listen up, washing machine Jill. You're supposed to submit questions. One to read. No. Good. We can pass on that.
So as far as of course, Horace Band of Fife, that's, we've established that. We'll probably mention it a few more times before we finish up. As far as accolades, though, I don't know if you saw, we do we did SWN 100 this year, which took into account win-loss record, title wins, retentions, what have you. And, of course, for your first proper full year, you ended up on this list, number 72, which I know that's a bit, it's not as high as possibly you'd hope for, but considering there was, I think if I'm right, there was over 365 wrestlers that competed in Scotland in 2022, and you were number 72. I don't know if you took that at all as accomplishment, but if you did, what were your thoughts? Was it just 71 people that you need to beat? Is that what you saw it as?
72nd.
72.
I'm not sure they make a reserve for a 72nd place. I'm not sure that's a spot on the podium. Billy, what was the criteria of this list? Was it ranking people based on hardness?
It was not. It was not, because, of course, you'd have to be number one. But it was win-loss record, which, you know, you still probably would still scored quite highly. There was just unfortunately, there were some people that won more titles, retained more titles during the year. But still, it's pretty good for first full year.
It's a small sample size, Billy. That's what it is. That's what's going against me. Because ultimately, I've got that 100% record. But as we've talked about previously, you know, you're only taking into account Tommy Cartel's work in pro wrestling. Mm-hmm. You're not taking into account Tommy Cartel's years on the streets of Fife before he decided to enlist in pro wrestling. 72nd, I'll take that. There's a lot of room for progress, isn't there?
Absolutely.
Where was Frank Gallo on that list?
Frank Gallo wasn't on the list. He didn't make it. I don't think he actually made I don't think he actually made the threshold of five matches to make the list.
Where was Judas Gray?
I don't think Judas Gray was on the list either.
Aye, this list just keeps getting better and better, though.
Again, Judas Gray didn't reach there was a five match threshold. He had his matches at Wrestle Carnival, but I don't think he didn't have enough matches in Scotland to make it this year. So, well, last year. So he's not on it either. I think the only person that may annoy you that beat you, I think Ashley Vega was higher up, but she is quite a travelled wrestler, I suppose we'll put it that way.
But as we've established, Billy, the criteria was dubious. It wasn't based on who's the hardest. It was based on wins, loss, titles,
exactly.
Matches. You know, I won't get upset over a ranking list. Who would do that?
Exactly. Crazy people would do that. Absolute mad folk. So when it comes to the hard, so your journey, we talked about your wrestling. So we've talked about that at length. We know once you became a licensed pro wrestler, we've talked about that. We know what's happened. You've wrestled in Tarbet of all places and Govan and all those kind of places. But we haven't really delved into your backstory, into how before pro wrestling. Is there any stories that you can tell, that you can divulge on this podcast of your time in Fife and how you worked your way up to being the hardest man in Fife?
I think, you know, it was always in my subconscious, something that was always there, Billy. As soon as I emerged from the womb, I knew there was something different about me, different to the other babies in the world. I was maybe just a wee bit harder. And I think I've proven that over the years. As my backstory, perhaps one day A&E will contact me, perhaps we'll make a big money documentary. There's a lot of trials and tribulations, Billy, that I don't want to give away for free on the SWN right now. Let's save that for when I'm on Jimmy Fallon. Let's save that for when I'm on the Today Show. When Tommy Cartel's in the big time. Then we can delve into Tommy Cartel's childhood.
Okay, well, I mean,
adolescence.
I'm not a journalist by any stretch of the imagination, so I'm not gonna try and Dr. Phil you here, and try and get into the mind of Tommy Cartel. That's just not. I don't get paid at all or enough to do that. I think that's it's a mind I maybe don't want to try and enter. I don't think I'm strong enough to do so.
Billy, I recall a fellow podcast host, Stone Cold Steve Austin. He posed a question to Dean Ambrose, and he asked about his childhood. Dean Ambrose, he went off the deep end after that, changed his name, started competing in all kind of mad death matches. You wouldn't want to do that to Tommy Kartel, would you?
First off,
Tommy Kartel in a death match.
Imagine Tommy Kartel bald. That would just be travesty.
Exactly. I think I'd rock it though, Billy. You know, skinheads are hard.
It's a common look nowadays, and you're anything but common. I suppose I could say there.
Take that as a compliment, Billy.
It was an attempt at one. I don't know. It could be misconstrued as something else, but it was definitely attended as a compliment. So as far as the future goes, we do have our questions that we like to ask everyone. I think we've built a little bit of rapport here. I think we haven't annoyed you, I don't think, in this little time.
You and I are bros.
At this moment in time, we've got two questions we ask everyone, and I'm interested for the answer to this one. So ask everyone, who would win in a fight, two sheep or one cow? Now I want to change that a little bit for you, because of course, hardest man in Fife, it's a question that I don't think it's worthy of your qualifications when it comes to this fight. So I would say, who would be the hardest for you to battle? Would you be able to take on, I don't know, a Highland cow rampaging at you, or two sheep? Would you have any difficulties against either opponent?
When we talk about a cow, Billy, are we talking about a bull?
You know what? It's open-ended here, but for the hardest man of Fife, I think we're going to have to go for a bull.
Cool. That was the challenge of sheep. It's just going to run away. So I'm assuming we're in an enclosed area here, Billy, for this.
We'll say so. We'll say it's in a... you know how you get the matadors? It's in one of those kind of arenas.
Okay, matador. So that's the Bulls' home turf. Mm-hmm. Just like people, they come into Tommy Kartel's ring when FPWA on Truth Nightclub. They come from all over, international talent, and they leave beaten. You know, I don't want to trod in the Bulls' territory. I don't want to go across to the Matador Arena. I'll take the two sheep, Billy. Now, these sheep aren't rams, are they? They don't have horns.
Got to be the hardest.
These are just too big.
The two hardest sheep you can find. Maybe in Wales.
Take the sheep. Aye, Billy. I'll take the sheep.
There we go. So maybe possibly next month that could be the match. I might be causing spoilers here. That could be two of your four opponents in the Fatal Five Way. I don't know. I'm just casting poor stereotypes over Wales here, and I apologize for anyone from Wales that gets offended by those particular aspersions. But you never know. Who knows? Wrestling's weird. We'll just leave that
question, Billy.
I was going to say, we'll leave that silence just to air. Sorry, I'm still a bit poorly. There we go. So, what would be your favorite? What's your favorite dinosaur?
Dinosaur. Got the hardest man in Fife here. You want to ask about dinosaurs like I'm some sort of archaeologist?
Anything. You know,
Jurassic.
You again, open-ended question. It could be anything. It could be we've had Harvey Sky, of course, one of your teammates that you've teamed with, seen Turkey Dinosaur. We've had Barney the Dinosaur. We've had Pokemon. But it could be anything.
I'll tell you what, Billy. There's a type of dinosaur that I'm thinking of. Pretty agile dinosaur. Usually spotted with a bigger, more lumbering, slow dinosaur. Funkadactyls.
Wonderful. That is a wonderful answer. And excellent. That's one of the best answers I've had of the season so far. And that's spot on. So, we covered your wrestling. We tried to delve into the pre free pro wrestling, Tommy Kartel. We failed, but it's fine. There's still time in the future to find out more.
Not Sigmund Freud.
So, exactly. Again, not qualified to do so, so I'm not even going to try and delve in further. Looking into the future, though, is there any hard men, any hard wrestlers, of course, regardless of gender, that you have your eye on, thinking, you know what, I want to get them? We've already spoke about the New Wave guys, but is there anyone that you're thinking, anyone, Floyd Mayweather, Steven Seagal, you know, who would be your dream Fatal Five-Way?
Well, as we touched upon it at the start of the interview, Billy, the reason Tommy Kartel got involved in the pro wrestling world is because of the ability, the potential that Tommy Kartel could be doing this 2-3 times a weekend if he remains in Scotland. So for Tommy Kartel, it's about trying to maximise that, try and realise that potential, just to be doing this more often than he's currently doing so. In terms of a dream Fatal Five-Way, at the end of the day, Billy, the most important thing for me is leaving with my hand raised. So it's, you know, who does Tommy Kartel, as we've, you know, already discovered, he's a strategic wrestler as well. Who would he have the best opportunity of retaining his title against? If you could clone Talon Jr. 4 times, that would be Tommy Kartel's ideal five-way. Don't get sick of beating up that kid.
So you're more for results than you are for accolade of say...
We're in a results-based industry, Billy. Nobody remembers the loser. The winner takes it all.
That's absolutely fair. So I think we've covered everything that I wanted to speak about. But is there anything that Tommy Kartel wanted to speak about or to just mention at all that you thought that my poor journalistic integrity hasn't mentioned at all in this podcast?
Billy, they say you're the Scottish Dave Meltzer.
So they do.
No, Tommy Kartel, would just like to plug his social media. If you've not seen Tommy Kartel's, you know, rump on a show, then you've missed the social media handle. It's at @TommyKartel_ on Instagram and Twitter, although Instagram's the primary place to find me. Tommy Kartel, would just like to say to any promoters listening, my availability's great. Set me up against your toughest, hardest men. Let's make some memories for the fans in attendance.
Wonderful. Well, thank you very much for taking the time. I said I want to get you on this podcast for a while since I saw so you're racking up these wins against huge, amazing talent. But no, thank you again for taking the time to speak to me.
Well, you keep checking out the Instagram. I'm sure there'll be more of that lovely content that you really appreciate coming very soon.
Excellent. Wonderful. Thank you.